When I was maybe 12 or 13, the president of the United States was John F. Kennedy, whom I greatly admired. And I used to try to see him whenever he would, you know, come to town, like just, you know, like a fanboy. And one time, on a crazy just notion, I went to the hotel where he stayed and thought maybe he'll just come out of the elevator when I'm here. And he did. He just came out of the elevator. I was in the lobby standing behind a potted plant. He looked around and he said, "Oh, hello, young man," and shook my hand. Later that day, I said to my sister, "I shook President Kennedy's hand, and I guess I'm not going to wash it for like 2 days, 2 weeks maybe, just to keep him on me." Did he stay on my hand? And for how long did he stay? So I went to Jack Gilbert at the University of Chicago.
I'm an ecologist, but I'm also a professor of surgery.
Jack studies bacteria.
Bacteria are a micron in size or less. They're really, 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 really small. And you have somewhere in the region of 30 trillion bacteria on your body or in your body at any given time.
These bacteria are all over your body, in your body, and together they're called your human microbiome.
Your body is an environment, right? Like a rocky terrain, and it's populated by bacteria and other microorganisms that create their own ecosystem.
And the thing is, each person's bacteria, each collection, is particular to him or herself. So mine are different from yours, yours are different from mine. So if the two of us shake hands, there's going to be a mingling of two distinct ecosystems of bacteria. So we decided to set up a repeat of the experience. I don't have President Kennedy around anymore, so I got myself a substitute President Kennedy.
Our nation,
Neil deGrasse Tyson,
will put a man on the moon and return him safely to the earth.
We're going to shake hands to see if there's an exchange of bacteria here.
We'll start. So give me your right hand.
Ready, set, go.
So Jack swabs both of our hands.
So we're going to swab it as much as possible.
It tickles.
So next step, you guys got to shake hands.
Okay.
Yep. Okay,
ready?
And then we shake.
Robert!
Hi,
good to meet
how
you.
Are you?
Good
nice to see you again.
Good to see you again. All right.
Okay. And then Jack swabs our hands again.
Okay, now Neil, right hand.
Go.
So a few weeks after the handshake, I called Jack and said, "Well, so what happened? What are the results?"
Scientifically, I expected there to be dual exchange, right?
Right.
But there was so little transfer from Neil to you. It was such a one-directional interaction. Just wasn't what I would have expected.
Was there nothing of Neil on me?
There was essentially nothing.
What did you learn about my effect on his hand?
This next stage is the most interesting. You had a dramatic impact upon his hand microbiome.
Yes.
Actually causing his...
No, I'm just saying.
He definitely picked up bacteria from you, and that led to quite a substantial disruption. I mean, that was quite shocking.
So in conclusion, when President Kennedy shook my hand, and I was really interested in how much of Kennedy would stay on me, suddenly I have to ask myself, wait a second, how much of me stayed on Kennedy?